what I need.
It's Wednesday, y'all, and today we're doing some fundraising. I'm your host, Mario Nunez. Get to pump that up there, Jessica. We want to hear that nice and loud. Get everybody excited. You've got your marching orders. Today we're doing fundraising here at WMNF. And, you know, a lot of times people will, they kind of recoil a little bit when this is taking place because it's just, sometimes it's a little bit of an arduous task to be calling in and to be, you know, asking for money and to help us stay on the air and all those good things. But you know what? We embrace it here at The Conversation. Again, I'm Mario Nunez, seated alongside my broadcast partner,
Joe King Carter.
The King is in the house. Where's my bell? I got to get my bell. I'll get it in just a minute. King, how was your week?
I had an excellent week. Thank you very much for asking.
Did you do anything special?
What did I do that was special? Well, you know, I have a new kitten in my house.
All right, okay.
And kitten energy is something special.
Can that kitten help us raise some funds today?
She's adorable.
Should have brought her in.
I'll sell photos of her to anybody who would like to buy one.
All right, maybe we can raffle some of those off. Hey, we've got a guest in studio here.
Well, I wouldn't say that exactly, but I am just wanting to thank one of our last donors for talking in with Carol Lyons from St. Pete. A nice donation, says, really enjoy the interviews. We learned so much, so we thank her for the support. And hope that everybody will keep supporting.
Keep supporting WMNF.
The Conversation. 813-239-9663 or WMNF.org.
Right off
Thank
the dome.
Thank you, Duncan.
Duncan, right. You didn't even have to look at the numbers. I still have to look at the numbers. That was right off the dome.
Well, it's after doing it this long, if you can't keep it in your
That's
head,
true. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Talking Animals hosted. And, you know, if you've not listened
Thank
to...
Thank you, Duncan.
Thank you, Duncan. Yeah, if you've not listened to that show in a while...
The kitten story is the Talking Animals guy, right?
There you go. That's what... That's,
there we go.
We sang you to us, Duncan. We sang you to us. Thank you so much for that. And continued donations, because that's what we're doing here today. We've got a goal that we need to reach. You were talking about your new kitten energy, and it's fierce.
It is. You can't have anything dangling.
Oh.
Her name is Lily.
All right.
And Lily is a sweetheart, and I have never had an indoor kitten. I've always had cats that have come to me. You know, they seek you out.
Yes.
They've always come to me as adults, and now I have a loving little kitten with me, and I have to tell you, it's a life changer. It's a very awesomely cool thing.
Kitten energy is exciting, to say the least. So let's give that number right up at the top, Joey, 813-239-9663, if you've got some extra ducats in your pocket.
Oh,
and
yes.
And you'd like to just lay them on us, this would be the time to do that. We've got operators standing by. We've got a room full of volunteers, as they always show up when we need them the most. But listen, let me digress for just a minute. For those of you that was a different intro, right, Joe? That was a different intro for our show today. We do have our regular intro queued up, and it's attached to a little description of what it is that we do here at The Conversation each and every week. We're kind of like the new kids on the block, aren't we?
We are. We're sort of the baby show.
I think so. We still have the training wheels on, and we're going to take those training wheels off soon enough, but we're going to ask Jessica to go ahead and play our regular intro so you can kind of get familiar with it if you've never heard it before. Sharing our stories connects us. Listen and be connected. Join us for The Conversation, meeting weekly at the intersection of community and culture. Hosted by Mario Nunez and Joe King Carter. Joe King Carter. I love the way that sounds. How you doing, Joe?
I'm doing great, baby. How are you?
It is Wednesday. It is hump day. And if it's Wednesday at noon, you know you've got to be listening to The Conversation, meeting weekly at the intersection of community and culture. Can we drill down a little bit? What does that mean exactly to those people that are new to our little enterprise here on Wednesdays?
Well, you know, WMNF Tampa, Florida, has all of these amazing public affairs shows, and they provide all kinds of incredible information. We're here to do something a little different and talk about culture and personal narratives and get to know people a little more And in that process, I believe that we will find that there is a connection between all of us when you find out what somebody else's story is about. It's not unlike your story. And so that's sort of where we want to go with this show.
Shout out to Michelle Cookson, who's watching. Shout out to Laura Lobo. And she, my prima's watching as well, Sandra Medullo. Thank you guys for tuning in to our Facebook Live. We also have Sean Canan, who just walked in, and he's going to help us today. He's going to help us pitch. We've got already some wonderful donations that have shown up, and I'd like to read them to you now and acknowledge those. And those that are watching at home, if you've got an extra $2 or $3 stuffed in between the cushions of your couch, this would be a great time to phone in.
I could make a joke right now about
give it to
Sean, vice presidential candidate, but I won't.
All right, we'll leave it right there. We'll leave it right there.
Coins in the cushion.
Somebody, listen, I was so focused on fundraising that the couch commentary eluded me. Can I say real quick that I'd like to say thank you so much for the $50 donation that came from Tanley Cabrera. Tanley, she says, we love the show. You're doing a great job. Thank you so much, Tanley.
Thank you, Tanley.
For your charitable donation. Also, another $50 from Tito. Tito is, for those of you that might or may not know, he's a cousin to the great Mark Barrow, who was at once a DJ here in WMNF, and we're trying desperately to get him back to come in with us.
Thank
you, Tito. Another $50. And also, I have, look at this one. This one came in just recently. It's Circle of Friends donation, and that's a good time to mention what Circle of Friends is. Joey, do you know what Circle of Friends donations are?
I do. It means you're in the Circle of Friends.
There you go. Let's ring a bell for Joe, who's just taking my lead. Actually, it's really easy. If you'd like to become a Circle of Friends donor, $10 a month, $20 a month, it comes right out of your checking account. It's real simple. It keeps you connected to our show. We send you a little decal that you can display on your car window, and it says you're a Circle of Friends. I have one here that's a Circle of Friends, $10 a month. It says, love you, Mario, with all our love and support, Mom and Dad. So thanks, Mom and Dad, for that generous
donation.
Thank
you, Mom and Dad. And by the way, the Circle of Friends is the most painless way to give and donate money to WMNF. It is an excellent way to do it because it becomes unconscious and subconscious, and it just happens automatically. And you are every day doing something good for your community.
Thanks to everyone who has donated so far. We're happy to ring that bell and hear those donations coming in. That's lovely. I'd like to hear from people who haven't donated yet. 813-239-9663. You can donate at WMNF.org. Hey, this is a brand new show, and we're really excited about the new blood and the new energy that's coming out of this show. So if you are happy that it's on the air, we would love to hear from you and say, hey, look, this is something that's worth supporting, that we like the energy that comes from this show. Give us a call right now and make that donation. 813-239-9663. You can donate on the web at WMNF.org.
Thank you, Sean. We have some incredible swag also. It's just not about donating your dollars without some reciprocity from our side, because we do have some incredible swag. Joe, you want to kind of, just name some of those wonderful...
Well, some of the ones that I find the most... I'll give you some of my favorites.
Dale.
How about that?
Dale.
One of them is the emergency crank radio. That thing is just amazing. What that means is that you will never not be in touch with media, regardless of what kind of power outages may happen at your home. Of course, hurricanes.
We're still in the season.
We're still in the season. And these crank radios are really beautiful. I have seen them. They're wonderful. They're well made. The technology is just amazing. You crank it up, and after cranking it for a period of time, you get so many moments, hours, minutes of radio coming in. The battery recharges through the cranking process.
There you go. And it's got a port also, Joe, that you can charge other features like your phones and things of that ilk.
So now you can crank and charge your phone. How about that? So the radio is...
It's for 188.5.
That's correct.
188.50 dollars is what will get you that emergency crank radio delivered directly to your house. Also, we have that license plate frame, which is really cool. Those of you that are watching online,
the birthday bundle.
Yep. If you're watching online on Facebook, you can see I'm going to show you the cool. So this year, WMNF celebrates its 45th year of broadcasting. For those of you that know anything
that
about,
that should barely be two.
There you go. For those of you that know anything about what a 45 record used to be, Joe, We know these 45s, right?
Wow.
You know that little disc, that little yellow, sometimes they were red, different colors.
Let us traverse back in time.
That yellow disc that you popped into the middle of the 45 so that you can play it on your record player. Well, that's that graces the cover of our shirt. I think these shirts are excellent and outstanding.
They're very cool.
And you can get one of your very own. And I'm looking at the list right now. Joey, what's the donation for this? I think it's $88. Is that correct? I believe it is.
The birthday bundle is $100.
There you go.
Yeah.
So listen, what we do here on the conversation, Joe, we talked about it for a minute, is we like to drill down on personal narratives. We like to interview our guests, even though they may come in here as authors, as accomplished musicians, sports figures, sports heroes. But we like to figure out just what makes them tick, where they were from, and so on and so
absolutely.
Forth.
Absolutely. And we touched on that in the soundbite that you played at the beginning. But what I'd like to express to people out there who are listening is that WMNF is so amazing. And there are these wonderful public forum, public issue shows that are on throughout the week. And they cover Wave Makers
Midpoint,
and they just go on and on. Sustainable living, they're amazing. And what we wanted to do here was something a little different because many of them are topic-driven, and that's good for you, the community consumer, because you're learning things about information that you need. But we had followed A Slice of Life, Randy Zimmerman's show, mm-hmm. and we wanted to sort of delve a little more into culture and personality and the connection between community and personal narratives. And my belief is that everybody has, of course, a great story. And the only reason those stories are not turned into books and sold on the bestsellers list is because not everybody's a writer. But everybody has a story.
There you go.
And so I think that what we want to do here and what we are doing is whoever comes on our show, it does not matter what the topic may end up being, mm-hmm. we will start with where did they come from? And that's, I think that it connects all of us because it celebrates our differences while celebrating also the things that we have in common.
One of our guests recently was a gentleman by the name of Chip Wiener. And Chip was, let's hear from Chip at this point. Let's hear from Chip in his own voice.
So, you know, Chip.
Don't call me Genie.
My thinking was he chip off the old block. Yeah. That's what I was thinking.
And the truth of the matter is, I am the spitting image of my father.
Then it could apply. Off the old block could absolutely apply.
Right. Yeah, okay. So that's very different than I thought it was going to be because right. I had a feeling it was Charles, just Chip and Charles.
A lot of times
Charles,
that's
Charles, Chip. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Now, you happen to be a guest today that I realized this morning, you sit at the intersection of everything that we are interested in doing here because Mario and I believe our audience and the community are very interested in cultural events and cultural affairs, cultural concepts. We're interested in art. We're interested in history. And you sit right firmly in that vortex, don't you?
I do.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. So let's talk a little bit about your early life in Tampa and what that was like for you.
Okay. As I think we've mentioned here before, I was a Gory Wilson plant kid, so South Tampa.
Pedigree.
Or not. I was not.
We know that. That story's coming. Story's coming.
Not in the popular crowd at all. I was, you know, when I was in high school, I was a long-haired musician. I played drums in the jazz band and then picked up guitar and played that afterwards. But, you know, no complaints. Living in South Tampa, it really is just this polished life, you know, depending on how you look at it. I don't care if you're a popular kid or not.
Right, right. You were a Davis Islander.
I was a Davis Islander.
Oh. There you go.
And fell in love with our city.
So essentially grew up on the island?
Essentially, I moved in when I was in high school because of family turmoil, but I essentially grew up on Davis Island.
Wow.
And again, charmed life over there.
Sure.
We were safe. We rode our bicycles everywhere.
Uh-huh.
Beautiful streets. We probably caused a little trouble over there. Nothing that I'll disclose right now, but it was a charmed life.
You weren't stealing cars, were you?
That depends on.
Uh-oh. Hey, he said we can ask him anything. Didn't
that's
he?
Right.
Yeah. Bring it. He said, "Bring it."
Bring it.
Okay.
Well, probably nothing more than a parental car. But
oh, still. Okay. All right. We sold our dad's car out of the driveway.
Well, you know, that's kind of interesting because one would not know this by looking at me today, but I used to be a addicted cyclist, and my favorite place to ride was on the island. Yeah. It was on Davis Island, yeah. And all the way out to Peter O'Knight and the yacht club and back. And that's interesting that you grew up there because it's a little bit otherworldly there. I mean, you're sort of in Tampa, but you're not in Tampa.
There is that divide.
Yeah. Island folks, yeah.
There is that divide. But if you, these days, people have this idea, and it is. It's a beautiful place, and it's sort of separate because it's across a bridge to get there. But back in the day, you know, I won't break into all of it, but I've done some studying, like, with other people that lived there, and maybe we'll talk about the Gandy collection, maybe we won't as far as upcoming projects, but he talks about, and I certainly witnessed it, on Davis Island, we were right across the canal from the phosphate mines and downwind from the water treatment plant. So, consistently covered and dusted by phosphate dust. And back in the day, I don't think it's still true, as you walked around the island at night and you threw a rock into the water, you could actually see it glow because there was so much phosphorescence in the water, and you could see fish swim by.
Wow.
But still, outside of the environmental stuff, definitely a charmed life.
Tampa was a much different experience.
Much different
back then. Mm-hmm. Much smaller population center.
Right.
And Davis Island always housed Tampa General Hospital, so right. TGH mm-hmm. was always there. I think really and truthfully, for those of us that didn't live on the island, didn't have that experience, there was this mystique about it. Yeah. There was this thing that you didn't really go on the island unless you had to.
It has canals.
Yeah, I know.
It has canals, and it also has a significant amount, it did at one time, of sort of Med-Rev architecture out there, too. So it always felt to me like...
Explain Med-Rev for those people that might not know.
Mediterranean Revival architecture.
I love it. Let's ring a bell on Med-Rev.
There we go. We all know it.
Well, it's
we know it, and we love it.
And again, it was fertile ground for the Berger brothers when they went in there with their cameras, and they recorded Davis Island more than most other parts of Tampa. Chip is an authority.
You're segueing a little early.
That's what we do here.
Yeah, okay.
No, but we're going to come back.
We're going to come back around and talk about the Birgit brothers.
D.P. Davis, when he developed Davis Island, really gave it this Venetian feel, because I've seen the old brochures, and part of the canals were that he wanted to sort of replicate at some level mm-hmm. the Venetian experience. And so that's why they have those Mediterranean buildings, and all of his hotels and all the commercial buildings over there were indeed Mediterranean Revival, because he was trying to create this whole thing on Davis Island.
So we absolutely love it when the door opens up and Sean Canaan walks in. And we love it even more when he walks in and he hands us, for those of you that are watching us on Facebook Live, these yellow papers. Because these yellow papers indicate that the phones are ringing and people are donating. And we thank you so very much. Sean, did you have something you wanted to share?
Well, we can thank these people first if you'd like. But at some point, I'd like to tell people about this emergency hand crank radio that
Please.
Is great for hurricane season. We've all been there. If we've lived in Florida for a while, the electricity's out. You have no contact with the outside world, really. Well, this is an emergency radio that WMNF can give you for a gift of for your donation of $188.50. And it has all these features. You can listen to AM, FM. That means you can listen to WMNF all day long while you're waiting to get rescued by the hard workers there putting up the electricity. And it also has a weather band, so you can listen to the emergency weather on this, and you can crank it by hand to power up the battery, or you can leave it in the sun to charge on the solar charging battery, and it has a flashlight as well. So all of these features are available in this emergency hand crank solar-powered emergency radio that's available for your donation of $188.50.
And Sean, it's so compact and so portable that you ladies can carry it in their handbags.
Or anyone that wants to can carry it in their handbag.
There you go. We love that. We love that because we are, after all, this is 2024, Sean.
Yeah. And in your pocket.
Yeah,
of course. You got to have baggy pants.
Yeah, there
you
go. It's in my pockets right now. Okay.
There you go.
Yeah, no, it's very small. It's a great size for, it's about flashlight size, roughly. And
correct.
It has an extendable antenna, so you can pick up a WMNF or the weather band. And you can get it by calling 813-239-239. 9663. You can go to WMNF.org and see what it looks like there, and you can make your donation there as well, or you can donate on the WMNF Community Radio app and support this great show on WMNF.
Thank you so much,
thank
Sean. Thank you so much. And thank you for bringing us these yellow papers. We love it when you do. You've got something you want to read?
I absolutely do. I'm just excited and proud. My dear friend, like a brother, Pete Otero, El Pidio Otero, has become a circle of friends for $132. I am so thrilled about this. I'm pretty sure it's his first time out, and it's exciting.
Thank you, Pete. Thank you. Ring one for Pete. And we also got a $25 donation from Barbara Diaz-Jaskowski. Barbara says, thank you for what you're doing. And she picked up one of the 45-year magnets, which will probably grace her refrigerator.
Thank you,
I'm
Barbara.
Thinking. Or
thank
you, know, sometimes
you, Pete.
You can put those on your car as well.
Yes.
Thank you, Sean. Sean's on his way out. He'll be back in just a little bit to bring us some more papelitos, as we like to say in the neighborhood, which is to say little papers. we have some information that we can read. Why don't you take the top one?
Absolutely.
You take the top one, I'll take the second one.
Absolutely. Well, you know, your support fuels independent voices in Tampa Bay. Every donation amplifies our community diverse perspectives. WMNF is a platform where underrepresented voices are heard, local issues are discussed, and community solutions are born. By supporting us, you are ensuring that our airwaves remain a true reflection of Tampa Bay's rich diversity. If you are ready to support community power, please call us at 813-239-9663 or go to WMNF.org.
How many M's was that?
WMNF.
So I'm going to read the second one here. Let me see if I can read it a little bit smoother than you did, King. These are cold reads,
by the
way.
Hey, wait a minute.
Democratic engagement. For 45 years, WMNF has empowered you to vote, choose, protest, and party. We're your longstanding source for informed citizenship and local activism. As we celebrate our 45th anniversary milestone, we renew our commitment to being your partner in democracy for decades to come. Support community engagement with a gift to WMNF today. Call 813-239-9663 or go to WMNF .org.
Yes.
Hey, that was pretty good.
I don't think it was much smoother than mine, but it was pretty good.
Just a little bit, but who's counting?
Yes.
Anyway, we're going to go to our next clip now because, you know, again, over the course of the first 12 weeks of our show, we've had some super interesting and informative guests. One of them was just last week, a gentleman by the name of Manuel Mendoza, journalist, career journalist. What a profile and portfolio he had. Lots of experiences, and he's going to tell us a little bit about himself right now.
You know, if you want to go back to, when I was at the Bergen Record, I was covering a town called Paramus, New Jersey, which used to be called the shopping mall capital of the world, because they were all over the place. And I was making my rounds of calls, and I had the police chief on the phone, and he mentioned that Trump was going to propose a new mall in Paramus, you know, to develop a new mall, and that the mayor knew all about it. And so I called the mayor and, you know, did my journalism thing, acted like I knew more than I knew. And he spilled the beans and just told me everything he knew. So this was it wasn't public yet. It was something in the works. So I called Trump's office. That back then, you know, and it's still true today, you know, you knew who to call. So there was a woman named Norma who was the gatekeeper for Trump. And, you know, we had her number. So I called Norma and told her what I knew. And she put Trump on the phone. And I was only on the phone with him for about a minute, but he confirmed that he was planning to do this, and so I ended up, you know, writing a story about that. And then about a month or two later, he came to meet with the editorial board of the paper, and so I was invited to sit in on that with my editor. And of course, Trump wasn't thrilled that I had, you know, essentially scooped his announcement. But, you know, Trump being Trump, my editor introduced me to him, and he said, oh, The famous Manny Mendoza.
How'd that make you feel, Primo? Listen, I've got an email here that they're coming in today. And again, let me just say for the record, we're grateful, so grateful that you guys are out there listening and contributing and sharing and asking questions, whether you're texting us or sending us emails. We realize that sometimes the calls don't come in, and that's only because they're kind of enthralled with the commentary. So they don't want to break that flow, and we get
that. We hope so, yes.
We get that because, really, we have to kind of guide the conversation from where we sit. And at times, we kind of get mesmerized, too, and we're just listening. So, But thank you. Thank you all for being out there listening. So an email here, it says, old newspaper gal here enjoying the show. Didn't catch Manny's last name. Please repeat it on the air or text it to me. This is thanks. It comes from Mama T. And I'll just say that Mama T, he just said it himself. But in case you missed it, it's Mendoza. So it's Manny Mendoza, Manuel Mendoza.
With a Z.
With a Z, exactly. With a
yeah,
Z.
And if you want to see my work, I have an author page at the Dallas Morning News, and the website is dallasnews.com. And if you just type in dallasnews.com/Manuel Mendoza, all one word, you'll see all my stories. Now, some of this is behind a paywall, and you may have to subscribe, but at least you can see the list of my work, and they may, some of them may not be member exclusives, but all my theater and dance criticism is on there at dallasnews.com/Manuel Mendoza.
And you've done a lot of work, man. I mean, you know, you've been hard at it now for, like you say, 30-plus years.
Yeah, really, it's like, if you count to this day, 30 years is when I worked for four newspapers over the course of almost 30 years, but I've now been a journalist since 1979. So this year is
45
years of
right?
journalism.
And what a great segue, because as you say 45 years, I'm looking over King's shoulder, and we've got here posted already in preparation for next week our fun drive thank you gifts, which of course we will be offering on next Wednesday's show. And so you started your journalism career, coincidentally, the same year that WMNF started broadcasting here in Tampa. Now, that's pretty cool, Manny. You know, we put that all together.
I did not know about MNF, but later on as an adult visiting here, I learned about MNF, and, oh, my God, it's a fantastic station. I always listen to it. I've been listening to it on a recent trip to Florida. I was listening to it, and I actually know I have a friend in Dallas who used to be a DJ at WMNF, and so I've even been there a couple times. I was when I made Stop the Presses, the American newspaper in peril, in 2008, I came to Tampa to show it at the Ybor City Film Festival, and I was on an MNF show to talk about it. And also, I was there another time when my friend David was in town at the same time as me, and we visited Flea mm-hmm. during his show, mm-hmm. who I believe is still the music.
He's still around? Yes, yes, yes. He's still here.
So, yeah, I know Flea, so I'm very intimate and familiar with M&M.
Here we go.
Well, the next time you're in town, promise us you'll make an appearance in studio. We'll give you another tour.
It's a fantastic resource. I think it's like, please, send all your spare money to WMNF.
Thank you, my brother. And if you'll credit it to the conversation, we'll even approve of it even more. Thank you, Manny. Thanks so much for that wonderful pitch. Sean.
Well, we have some people to thank for the conversation, but I also first want to thank some people who donated right at the end of Talking Animals. And Darian from Tampa has donated $35 to Talking Animals, loves the show, and is getting the Pocket Monkey. And also Susie Schonder from Tampa is donating $35 and is getting a T-shirt. They're donating to several different shows and getting a T-shirt. So I appreciate those donors that for Talking Animals. And by the way, Talking Animals did make its goal, so congratulations to them.
Yeah, there's Talking Animals.
Now it's our turn to have the conversation. You know, all of the hosted shows for News and Public Affairs have made their goals so far, so we have to pick it up right now for the conversation. We still have a few hundred dollars to go, I think, right?
That's what I'm thinking as well. And I have it on good account that we have a challenge. We have a challenge issued from Anonymous, who is saying that for the next $100 donation, we will match that $100. Anonymous, thank you so much for issuing that challenge. And if you're out there and you can help us out with a $100 donation right now, that donation will be matched. In addition, you can get...
I love that, Anonymous.
Nice merchandise as well. And the merchandise, one of the things is the shirt that we're wearing right now. And if you're watching us on Facebook Live, boy, it's a sexy shirt. I love this shirt. It's a good-looking shirt. Thank you, Sean. Thank you for that. And one more. We have a contribution here for $27.10. Love that amount. It's very, very specific. From Rhonda Dosal. Rhonda, thank you so much.
Rhonda, thank you, Rhonda.
For being a listener and for supporting us here at WMNF on The Conversation, meeting weekly at the intersection of community
and culture.
Yes.
And love and love.
And more love than you can even think about. Joy, what do you got to say for yourself?
Well,
something about unique programming, perhaps?
Yeah, unique programming. We can talk about that, certainly. From grassroots news to eclectic music, WMNF offers content you won't find anywhere else on the dial. Our volunteer programmers bring passion and expertise to every show, introducing you to new artists, genres, and ideas. We're not bound by commercial playlists or corporate agendas. Our content is as diverse as our community. Support WMNF's diverse programming by calling 813-239-9663 or online at wmf.org.
And local focus. We can talk about local focus. You know, we're more than radio. Really and truthfully, we're neighbors. WMNF keeps you contacted to what's happening in your community. Our reporters are on the ground covering local stories that matter to you, but often get overlooked by larger media outlets. From city council meetings to community events, we're your eyes and ears in the Tampa Bay area. Strengthen local journalism with a gift today by calling 813-239-9663 or visiting WMNF.org. Come on, Joey, let's keep reading these. They're rolling off the tongue.
These are wonderful. I wonder
who
wrote these.
You go.
No corporate overlords here. Mm-hmm. For 45 years and counting. Your contributions have kept us independent and accountable only to our listeners for nearly half a century.
That's 50
45 years.
45.
This time-tested model allows us to prioritize public interest over profit. Oh, my God, we need it so much. Ensuring that our content remains free from commercial influences. Maintain our independence by calling 813-239-9663 and donating online at WMNF.org.
One more for you guys. Election information. So it says here, stay informed on local and national elections. And after all, we're in the election season presently. WMNF is your unbiased source for candidate forums and ballot breakdowns. We dig deep into the issues, go beyond sound bites, and provide the context you need to make informed decisions. Our election coverage is designed to empower you as a voter. For unbiased election coverage, support us at 813-239-9663 or online at WMNF.org. Joey, you've worked out a little schematic here that
I think... Well, you know, I've got to tell you something.
Share this with our audience.
Of course. How many people out there believe in the dream world, the magic of the dream world? It's an amazing place. And I've been interested in dreaming, as most of us have, my entire life. And I had a dream last night. And in my dream, my sixth grade math teacher... Mr. Strasbaugh.
There you go.
Came to me in the dream. Now, this is probably my subconscious talking to my conscious self. I don't know what it was. Maybe it's from the ethers. But anyway, the math that came out in this dream for me was kind of interesting. I started realizing that WMNF, this amazing resource in our community, what is it worth to you as a listener? Is it worth a dollar a day? For me, it would be worth much more than a dollar a day. But if you paid a dollar a day, you'd be paying $365 a year to be a member of WMNF and to listen. Well, let's say that you only paid 50 cents a day, then it would be $182.50. Let's say that you paid 25 cents a day, then it would only be $91.25. 25 cents a day, ladies and gentlemen, that's not much money for something that is so amazing in your life. But I've actually taking it down to one more level. If you paid a dime a day, it would be $36.50. Is there someone out there that has $36.50
3650 going once.
3650 going twice.
3650 going three times. Sold for 3650. Now, if you can't reach into your pocket and find a dime a day,
folks,
Joe's going to have to leave the show.
Wait a minute.
Randy Zimmerman, our general manager, has walked in the studio, and she is going to grace us now with her dulcet tones. And Randy, what say you?
So I'm going to give you some numbers.
Okay, here we go.
So far, you have raised $319.
That's not enough.
And you need $481.
Come on, $481.
Can be done in 20 minutes, especially for a show as wonderful as The Conversation.
Oh, thank you, Randy.
You guys, I know we do radio, but you guys look adorable. Just adorable.
Well, we're on Facebook Live right now.
And you're matching WM&F shirts. This is the new artist edition. It is just, and really, if you're on Facebook Live, these guys are really freaking cute. So
Thank you, Randy.
You should get $481 just for being adorable.
Oh, my God.
Dressed as you are.
Oh, let's do that, guys. Come on, don't let Randy down. Don't let Randy down. $481.
But what's so great about The Conversation, and again, what WM&F does, which is so special, because we are deeply committed to grassroots voices, voices from the bottom up, rather than listening to people at the top all the time, which is kind of who we're left with when you just have corporate-sponsored media, especially as it's diminishing over and over again. We are so committed to bringing voices from the grassroots, and that's like the essence of The Conversation.
Yes.
Just talk to me. Let's have a conversation. Let's talk about it. Say who you are. I'm going to listen. And we do that a little teeny tiny bit in some of that mainstream media, and maybe we'll get a 5-second soundbite from somebody who's in distress, or the average everyday citizen, 10-15 seconds, but not here at WM&F, and certainly not on The Conversation. So we want independent media. We want to have conversations with each other. We want to be civil. We want to be thoughtful. We want to be rational. And the essence of WM&F, the essence of community radio, is those grassroots voices, and not just for the sake of voices, but for a larger mission, because we believe we're going to have a peaceful, sustainable, and a just world if we just talk to one another.
That's well said.
That's it.
Amen.
Randy.
So there's a saying.
You're amazing, Randy.
Randy, there's a saying that my grandfather always used to tell me when, I was little. I always heard him say it in Spanish. It says, hablando se entiende la gente. Hablando, talking, mm-hmm. se entiende la gente. People understand each other.
Yeah.
So you got to talk.
We're hardwired to do it.
Yes.
Human beings are hardwired to do it. And if that's what you believe in, right? If you want to see these adorable guys in these adorable shirts.
Love it.
And wear one yourself. Go to the supermarket, go wherever you go, and see your adorable friends wearing this olive green shirt with Beautiful. The 45 in the middle, celebrating 45 years of independent
here,
media
here.
Here in the Tampa Bay area.
It's definitely my palette.
We need to hear from you. 813-239-9663. Again, 813-239-9663. Please call now.
Please call, folks.
We really do need your support.
It's
how community radio happens. Hit that donate button at WMNF.org. Hit the donate button on your WMNF app right now. That's what we need to hear from, folks.
Thank
$481.
You,
Randy. That's what you got.
We can do it. In the last 15 or so minutes to go, we can definitely
come on, folks.
Do it. We've got another soundbite that we want to share with you. It's from Kelly Buttermore and Justin Peters. And they were graced our studio here. They were the two improvisational actors that came to us via the Commodore. Let's listen to what they have to say.
The Sarah McLachlan thing, right? I told you, I was all into that, right? All in.
Right.
And so the things in my life that I was born or perhaps nurtured this quality where for better or worse, I either love something and need to be completely immersed in that thing or, you know, like whatever it is, or I don't care. Mm. So for me, I don't like anything. I either love it or I'm not there.
No ambivalence from Miss Kelly.
Interesting.
She doesn't have time for that.
No, I don't have time for that.
We can appreciate that.
And so for me, my journey to improv came out of one of those periods of my life where I found a thing. So for me, it was Saturday Night Live. So when I was in college, it was Tina Fey, Rachel Dratch, Amy Poehler, all those folks who came out of improv, all the really strong era of women on that show. I became very invested in that show. I went to college in Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. Shout out Mount Holyoke College. I went to college in Massachusetts. While I was in college, I would make time somehow to come down to New York City and to do this thing where I would, you can sleep on the street to get standby tickets to Saturday Night Live. Do you know this?
I'm not familiar with
the way that, and Justin will get to talk
about
it.
Tell them about the line captains.
Oh, yes. So the way that they do a lottery system for SNL tickets, or they did 20 years ago. I don't know what they do now. But it's really hard to get because the studio is small. There's only so many shows, and your chances of getting picked there are really, really slim. You can put your email in, and a year later, they'll say you can't come. So what you can do instead is there is a standby line where they give out tickets, or they did, again, this is now over 20 years ago, where they would give out tickets based on a number at 7 in the morning on Saturday, Mercy. Which means that you, the earlier you get there, the higher your number is and the higher likelihood you might get in to see the show if there's a few empty seats. So what I came to learn was that the standby line had its own culture. It was captained by these two people, this one guy in particular and his wife. This guy named Lewis, he'd done standby for every single Saturday Night Live show since the very first show.
Wow.
In 1975.
Which we're about to have the 50th and a golden anniversary.
Exactly. Right. 50 years. And so after 10 years, Lorne Michaels gave this guy two tickets, but he came to the line anyway. So he felt that the line was his. I don't think he's there anymore, but this was a whole thing, and I became to know that the line was its own ecosystem, which was very interesting. And so through that, I came to know what improv was, because I learned that these women that I admired had come out of improv, and I started to go see improv shows at the Upright Citizens Brigade, and I'll never forget, like, the first improv show you see is so integral to your journey, because if it sucks, you're just like, well, that's not a thing. But for me, it was like, I want to do that.
Magical.
I want to learn how to do that. That's magic. I want to learn that. And so that was my journey. And so my goal when I moved to New York at the age of 22 was to climb the ladder and try to get to SNL myself. But along the way, I had started with improv as a stepping stone, but I came to take a exit ramp and like see it for what it was, which was a beautiful thing. But I've talked a lot, as Justin's true.
And I can see you doing a little Debbie Downer and being a little Rachel Dratch from time to time.
I mean, Justin will tell you that.
She was one of my favorites.
So before we get to Justin, let me ask you then, you're causing me to think about this. Is it that, would it be that it seems to me that a certain kind of personality would attract to becoming a Jerry Seinfeld, a person that wants to write their material and perform it? And then there's a certain kind of person that's probably attracted to sketch comedy, which is obviously more theatrical and a lot of different components. And it seems to me that all of those people you're talking about on Saturday Night Live, if my memory is correct, they all came out of improvisational theater.
Yeah, Second City was right
there. Second City and all of that stuff.
Many of them did, yeah.
Many of them did. So would this kind of bug that caught you, would not be the same bug that would catch somebody to be a stand-up comic? I'm curious.
This is a great question. So I can't speak as much to sketch. I think sketch is a different animal than improv, but I think improv, it's collaborative. And so, and it's built, you can't do it alone. Well, you can do it alone, but like, you can't do it without another person. And so there's something about the letting go of the need to control the material.
Psychotherapy to be so structured, yeah.
Is it psychotherapeutic in a sense? I mean, are you growing yourself as you're doing it?
Well, yeah, because like when you start doing improv, and I still do this sometimes, I'm guilty of this, you come in with a preconceived, you get a suggestion, and your brain starts going, right? But the brain is improv's enemy, you see.
It's rare to find someone who's both an excellent stand-up comic and an excellent improv.
So they're very different.
They're different skill sets. Yeah, I think that's right. I think it's like improv, like your brain is not your friend. You have to let go. You have to give yourself over to the scene. Whereas stand-up, I would say that's a different
Justin, I'm going to throw this at you real quick, and yeah. It just popped into my head as Kelly was describing all of that. It's almost as if you can say the skill set that is required to be a really effective improvisational actor will afford you, if you wanted to delve into that more structured comedy, to be a good stand-up comic as well. I don't know that it works necessarily the other way.
Or sketch person.
Does a comedic actor with all the sense of timing and all the skill and the nuance can be an excellent dramatic actor, because you can harness that and become an excellent focused dramatic actor. I don't think it works the other way.
No, it doesn't. I mean, if you can really put yourself in that sort of like Zen flow state where you come up on stage with nothing, not an idea, not a plan, just nothing, and are comfortable with nothing, and comfortable enough with your own intellectual fluidity and your own innate charisma to trust that no matter what happens next, you'll be fine. You can make something entertaining out of absolutely nothing. Then that, when you can get yourself to that state, I think it does instill the sort of confidence that, you know, can translate to other formats.
Justin, that was masterful what you just said.
I can't wait to hear this in the archives.
It's a coffee table quote.
Because right I didn't write it down, brother, but that's going to be on the next T-shirt. Yeah, make, okay? The conversation and all that's on the back. I'm
you
just
must become
that.
Comfortable with nothing.
Yeah,
it's very zen.
No, I like you have to be comfortable with your intellectual fluidity, and there was a second part to that too.
Yeah.
We'll go back and listen to it in the archives. Don't worry, I'm not asking you to catch it twice.
I don't know what I say. I'm coming in here with nothing right now.
All right, there you go.
Went into that trance-like
state. You
started
with nothing.
But that's the beauty of what improvisational and the type of improvisational comedy that you guys do. Wonderful. We went into like the Zen-like flow trance, and we're back now. And we're looking for money. We're looking for money. Joe, you got any money in your pockets?
I don't have enough, and I need more.
I like that, too.
Yeah,
I like
we need
that
more
lot.
Here at WMNF.org.
813-239-9663. We see you out there watching. The people that are watching on Facebook Live, this is your time to shine. This is your time to pick up your phone and give us a call. We got to leave here meeting our goal. We've got about $350 left to go.
Anybody
481. How much? 481?
481.
481? Damn. Come on, y'all.
Come on, folks.
481, that's low-hanging fruit. You spend that on a weekend.
What's nice about WMNF is we have both opportunities for people to collect thank you gifts, whether they can only give $25 or if they can give as much as $100, and we've got a variety of special packages at $245. You can even break that up over time into $25 a month donations until you've paid for it, or you can become a member of our Circle of Friends.
Circle of Friends.
Which is so important for this station. These are people who are so deeply committed to WMNF.
Yes.
And at the same time, they want to kind of set it and forget it, right?
Correct.
It's what I do. What I did was I added up how much I give the station on an annual basis, and I divided by 12, and I just put it on my credit card, and I set it and forget it, and I don't have to think about it. And I'm a member of the Circle of Friends.
As am I.
But it took years for me to have enough money, regular income, because I worked 3 part-time jobs for the longest time, until I could become a member of the Circle of Friends. And so now I'm privileged enough to do that and be a member, and it's great. And again, for budgeting reasons, it is so important to know what our monthly income is going to be and to be able to budget for that into the future, year after year.
Yes.
It's so helpful. So if you want to become a member of the Circle of Friends, you can do so for as little as $5 a month.
Come on, y'all.
That gives you a $60 a year donation, and you can even pick up some of our really cool gifts like the magnet or the sticker or the bumper sticker. People have the power bumper stickers, like one of my favorites.
Come down here. We'll give you something, folks.
Yeah, and listen,
we'll give you something.
So we have some swag of our own. You know,
you have your own swag?
Yeah, we do. We do have our own swag, and I think
is
the shirt still in here? Because I was going to show it to the
right
folks
here
that are watching us on Facebook
there
Live.
Got it.
There it is.
But again, 813-239-9663 or hit donate at WMNF.org. Look at that conversation.
Isn't that cool, Randy?
It's a black t-shirt with some hats and a microphone in between, and it says WMNF.org, Wednesdays at noon, 88.5 FM. The
Look
conversation.
At that.
Oh, and that's the back. So on the front, you've kind of got your
little pocket
image. Your logo there on the pocket. Very sweet.
Yeah.
Very
sweet. If you'd like to get one of those, well, just we can make that happen. Just give us a call, 813-239-9663.
What kind of donation for that?
Let's go with $50. What do you think?
A $50 donation for a conversation shirt.
And Joe is just telling me now, he's whispering to me in my ear, that for the next $100 donation, watch this one. This is going to be even better. So we'll match that donation. $100 will match that donation, which will automatically bump it up to $200. And Joe is telling me that if you'd like to have lunch with the hosts of the Tampa Native Show, where am I going with this? Of the conversation, I had a subliminal moment there.
We can
do that.
Where are we going?
Yeah, well, we can go right over here to the Flan Factory, which is pretty good.
Yes.
I hear that.
Isn't it good, Randy?
I have eaten there. The flan is delicious.
The flan is delicious. The Cuban sandwiches aren't bad.
At the Flan Factory. Yes. And there are other people who swear that the Flan Factory has the most original Cuban sandwich here in the Tampa Bay area. That is what some people say.
And they call it the Tampeño.
Isn't that
interesting? They call it the Tampeño.
Actually, it's very reminiscent of the Mixto sandwich that the
From
Cigar
yesteryear
was made.
That's right.
Interesting.
That's very true.
Hmm?
Yeah,
very
the
cool
ownership has gone through painstaking efforts to make sure that they have been classically true to the original Cuban sandwich formulation, and they press it there. Of course they do. So anyway, if you'd like to have lunch with us, $100 donation, we'll match that donation. Joe and I, we can't come pick you up because we don't know where you live.
No.
But we can certainly meet you there.
And we're pretty pleasant lunch partners.
You have to wear your matching t-shirts.
We will.
Yeah, and
because we're adorable.
Yeah.
So says our general manager, Randy
Zimmerman.
And we
know which fork to use. So.
Well, you don't use a fork. Now, when you're eating a Cuban sandwich, you don't. Maybe if you're eating yuca fries, you might use a fork, but not necessarily when you're eating.
Or the frito, what's that called? The rice and...
No, that's the arroz chino. Arroz frito.
Can I ask you guys
a
question?
Of course.
So what was so special? I mean, I can tell you what I thought was special about the last interview that you did with the improv folks, but...
That was great.
What were the highlights? Why was that interview so special for you?
I think for me it was because, particularly Kelly, Justin is a writer and he speaks incredibly well. Kelly revealed this thing, that this energy that must come to front, to bear. You must expose a vulnerability when you do this. And that's something that I think a lot of people never do in their lives. Mm. It's kind of like being, if I may be slightly off color, naked in public. It's sort of like, boom, you're going to go up on stage and somebody's going to say, frozen snow peas, and you're going to come up with something with that. And somehow you're going to make that, it's got to come from deep, it's got to come out of you, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there isn't a lot of time for ego. There isn't a lot of time for manipulating concept. It's just like, I got to do this. And that really intrigued me because I think this for her is a, it's meaningful at a level that's almost, I think I said it was like Zen, but it's
Zen
almost
flow.
Like a, I don't want to say religious, but like a spiritual, there's kind of a spiritual aspect to this that I find fascinating.
So one of the things I say about WMNF radio all the time is we hit you in the head and the heart at the same time. And that's kind of the essence of that interview, right? Mm. That you have both the essence of a human being, all of our feelings, all of our emotions, but talking about it in a very intellectual and spiritual way. And if that's the kind of thing that you like, if that's the kind of, because you have to fund it. It doesn't happen in mainstream media whenever you want it to. So please give us a call, 813-239-9663.
You won't find that in the corporate world.
Nope, not at all.
You won't find that.
People are afraid of that. I don't want to hear about other people. I don't want to feel other people. No, I don't want to have a more peaceful world.
Right.
I wanted to have the world that I want to create for whatever the profit margin
and
is.
And part of the reason that we're alternative radio is because it's an alternative to that stuff that you are being fed day in and day out. All of the shows that we have are talking about alternatives to the food industry, alternatives to the energy industry. This is what we're talking about at WMNF. Mario and I are talking about alternatives to connection and how those connections work. You get to hear that here.
Bad times are coming and I'm